The next topic of the lesson, new initiatives in the Rajiv Gandhi era. So Rajiv Gandhi won the unprecedented victory in elections. After that, Rajiv Gandhi focused on the peace. That is, he has solved the problem of the Assam, Punjab, and not only our internal issues but also the international issues like Sri Lanka. So there was a dispute in between the Sinhalese and the Tamilians. Internal disputes were there in Sri Lanka. So to give support, Rajiv Gandhi sent the Indian Armed Forces to the Sri Lanka. But later in 1989, Sri Lankan government said to withdraw the support. So that's why Rajiv Gandhi called back the Indian Armed Force. And after that, he concentrated on the poverty actually. So in his famous speech, he said that the fruits of the development were not reaching faithfully to the poor people. In his famous speech, he said that from 1 rupee, it is barely reaching 15 paise to the poor people. So he concentrated on the poverty, and the development was made by the Rajiv Gandhi, but the story of the poor will remain the same. So that's why he wanted to involve the backward caste, Dalits and women in the governance. So he initiated the Panchayat Raj. Panchayat Raj system. But this was also criticized by the opponents that Rajiv Gandhi suggested this system just to degrade their power in the states. So he faced many critics from the opponents, and next he concentrated on the economy. So to develop the economy, to develop the Indian economy, he has introduced in his first budget in the year 1985 liberalization system. So under this, he concentrated mainly on the technology of India, and he initiated the telecom revolution. So under this, he invited the computer and technology and communication technology in India through the satellite technology. So because of Rajiv Gandhi only, nowadays we are enjoying what all the technologies we have in India. We'll go for the next topic. The another heading of the lesson, rise of communalism and corruption in high places. So here we can say that the old religious issues and caste differences were repacked and used for the political mobilization. In the year 1985, Supreme Court given a judgment in the Shah Bano case that he had divorced from her husband and he has to get the maintenance from her husband. But here the religious heads did not accept for this, that the judiciary is involving in the matters of the religious, so it is not fair. So the religious heads did not accept for that, and they said that judiciary did not have any right to involve in the religious matters. So again the judgment was changed by the Supreme Court that the Shah Bano will get the maintenance from the religious institutions just for 3 months. So here we can observe that the judgment even has changed with the involvement of the political parties as well as with the involvement of the religious. So next we'll go for the, at the same time we have another controversy of Ayodhya. It means in Ayodhya there was a conflict between the Hindus and Muslims that Ayodhya is belongs to actually Hindus. The Hindu people were arguing like this, and the Muslim people were arguing like it was belongs to the Muslims. Hindus, they said that it is a birthplace of Lord Rama, so that it belongs to Hindus. And the Muslims were arguing that they have the Babri Masjid from decades onwards, so it is belongs to the Muslims. So there is a conflict between the Hindus and Muslims. So in this matter, the Supreme Court again involved and given judgment that the Masjid, the mosque, will be closed all the days in the year except one day. That means only one day it will be open and remaining all the days it will be closed. But later the political parties and the religious involved in the matter of the judgment, and again in the 1986 the Supreme Court changed its decision, judgment, that all the days in the year the mosque will be opened and Hindus will be allowed on daily basis for the visit. So here we can observe that the political parties are involving in the matter of the Supreme Court judgment for the support in the people. So next, around the same time the charges were issued on several political leaders that they have received directly and indirectly bribes from the Swedish manufacturing company who are supplying arms to the Indian army. So though the charges were not proved clearly by any political party, but this situation was taken as a chance by the political leaders, opponents, for the promotions. For example, V.P. Singh. So in the year 1989 campaigning, this was made huge promotions, and later, however, the Congress party won the majority, but the party was unable to form its own government and it was merged, collided with the Janata Dal party, and here comes the first coalition government.